mark the Independence Day, our cries are high that we need help from the international community. We need help from the British public opinion, and we hope that the British people will put pressure, we exert pressure on the government to change track. That policy produces what we see, what we saw. You are in UK, you have at risk.
Me out standing outside, I'd been kicked out, and there was you. And but what you had, what, did you know that in fact they are armed officers, right? That woman, she would have been armed. And if you had got near the car, the car accelerated, woof, like that, you could have been in as much danger as when you were up on the roof last night. So Musa has a consistent history. But the other point is that, keep it up, it is about democracy. History is on everybody's side here. And the immediate thing that everybody here can do is, has to be that critical change.
On their own feet in some sense, in all of this, because they have been there for 200 years with British support. And this, yeah, the Saudi is much more recent, and the United Arab Emirates is kind of a new creation as well. So, it, in some ways, I don't think it is really there. The regional influence is the historical British relationship with Al Khalifa, which is the big obstacle that we're facing. But
they know things like this happen. But they don't get the right, the profile they warrant and deserve. The incidences I'm talking about, the Egyptian cases, I picked up on the street on the edge of road. People were talking and gossiping about it quite openly, yet they weren't picked up by the mainstream media. The other instance, which we shouldn't forget actually as well, is the murder of a manservant in Landmark Hotel, which was actually, people shouldn't forget, was by a Saudi prince, a cousin of Mohammed bin Salman. Now, you know, we're used to having and entertaining these regimes during the summer, but actually people do realise what they get up to when they're here in London. And I think that needs to be exposed, not just with, you know, how they drive their cars and parking and things like this, but that, other things that happen between their four walls. That's something which I think does need exposing a lot more, and the extent to which we're in cahoots with.
Who, as Lyndon has reminded us, are essentially behind this process. It's not Britain, it is the British ruling class and their state. This is the problem, the nature of the problem. I would also simply urge that members and associates of any human rights groups based in Britain, Amnesty International or whoever, it would be wonderful if an arrangement could be made for a recording of this meeting and the important contributions made to be posted on their websites.
Talks about. So one's got to perhaps look at the strategy of the Bahrain opposition, both here and within Bahrain. What are their demands? And if you look at on a global situation, countries like Cuba, Nicaragua, didn't bring about change by knocking on the doors of the elite in Washington, London, or Paris. They did it by themselves. And they're
coming every 10 years is giving an alarm to everyone. There is a problem in Bahrain. There is non-stable political regime. And the will of the people is not being represented in this regime. So the solution is a political solution, not building a naval base in Bahrain. It's a political solution. Not sending a new boat to the Persian Gulf or to the Arab Gulf. But why UK government, since that day until today, is not taking the route of a political solution. It's not asking the people properly.
But the police knew that if they didn't intervene within a minute or two, he could have become a Khashoggi, because they saw, and you'll see in the film, that very clear how his life was in an imminent danger. And this is why they took the decision to storm the embassy. Until now, we didn't hear that the Foreign Office had summoned the Bahraini ambassador or threatened to cut relations or ask for the death squads which were there on the rooftop to be handed to the British police. Nothing, as if nothing has happened. Let us see what this video says, and we judge for ourselves.
Yes.
What is the background?